Hi, my name is Dr. Ashesh Buch. I'm an interventional cardiologist. I work for Chesapeake Regional Healthcare. Interventional cardiology is essentially, I'm a plumber, to put it very crudely. I'm a plumber of arteries that supply the heart. One of the commonest causes of death and issues in the Western world is what we call coronary artery disease, which is fatty buildup in the arteries. And when that gets quite severe, people can get chest pain. The medical term being angina, for chest pain coming from the heart due to blockages or narrowings of the arteries. And interventional cardiology is a specialty where we can open up those arteries and put stents in them to increase the, get rid of the blockages and improve the blood flow to the heart and thereby relieve the patient's symptoms of chest pain or breathlessness. So that's essentially what it is. And the procedures we do are catheter based. So rather than open heart surgery, which obviously means opening up somebody, we put tubes either into the wrist or the top of the leg, and we access the heart arteries through catheters we thread up. So if you follow any artery back, you get back to the heart. The thing that prompted me wanted to do medicine, I've always been slightly scientifically orientated, but didn't want to have a career or a job that was bench-based, lab-based. I like interacting with people, and medicine is essentially an art and a science, if we're being truthful about it. And it offers both the intellectual interest, but also the human interest, where you're using your knowledge to help people feel better. Most of what we do in medicine is not curing, is actually managing chronic conditions that cause suffering, cause problems to all of us, be it pain in the knee or be it chest pain or whatever it may be. And I find that very rewarding. So that's why I went into medicine. And why cardiology and interventional cardiology? It has a good mix of good clinical care that you can give in the office or on the floor, and some procedures which, if you use in the right patients and in the right way, can dramatically improve people's quality of life. So it's very rewarding in that sense to do that. The typical symptoms of a heart attack are described as a crushing chest pain, usually in the center of the chest or towards the left side, that can spread to the neck or the arm or the jaw and the left arm. But in a large number of people, they don't get the crushing chest ache. And in fact, I think if we're being self-critical, a lot of the public education campaigns all over the world have focused excessively on that crushing heavy pain, when in fact it can be any constant unremitting sensation that doesn't go away in the chest. And it can be a discomfort, it doesn't have to be severe, there's no relationship between the severity of the chest pain and the size of the heart attack, believe it or not. It may or may not spread to the neck or the arm or the jaw. But of course, if that does, that increases the chance it is. And sometimes the pain can be a burning sensation. And so many people misconstrue and mistake it for heartburn. So first of all, it's not always a crushing chest pain. It can be an ache, it can be discomfort, it can be a burning pain. Not infrequently it's associated with nausea or sweating, and if it's a sweating, it's often a cold sweat, but not always so. And an awful lot of patients, they don't get chest pain at all. The elderly and people who have diabetes may not get chest pain at all. They may get breathlessness, nausea, fatigue, but basically it's something that suddenly starts. Because the heart attack is due to an artery going from being narrowed but open, but suddenly blocked. And when that happens, not enough blood is getting to the muscle beyond it. And that's what's causing the symptoms. So it's usually a rapid onset symptom that doesn't go away. And if it isn't chest pain, they can get nausea, they can get chest pain, or chest discomfort or breathlessness. In women, women not infrequently may get slightly different modes of presentation in terms of symptoms. It's something that we're being increasingly aware of as we realize that conditions, not just cardiac conditions, can present differently according to gender, race, etc. And so in women, there can sometimes be a sharp chest pain. Again, it may not be your classic crushing and severe. They often have breathlessness, sweating, nausea. Some people have dizziness. But the key in all this is something has happened suddenly. It is not going away, and people feel unwell or not quite right. And essentially, if that happens, the best thing to do is to call for help and call 911. All of us read in the media every day on our smartphones and other things, you shouldn't eat this, you shouldn't eat that, this thing's now unhealthy and this thing's not. And it's very confusing. So the simple things are lifestyle, and in those people who do have heart disease, there is a role for pills. So lifestyle is for everyone, whether or not they have heart disease or not. If you don't have heart disease, you don't want to get it, and if you've got it, you don't want it to progress. So maintaining a healthy weight, keeping body fat down is good. Avoiding smoking, absolutely avoiding cigarettes and tobacco products. Exercise. We know that exercise really is the magic drug, believe it or not. It is the one thing that helps every single organ system in the body and every single condition. And we know that people who keep active, walk plenty, basically do as much in their day-to-day life, whether they're active and up and about, are likely to live longer and less likely to have heart issues. So the lifestyle bit applies for everyone, and even more so for people who have proven heart disease, who have angina, who had issues with their heart, have had heart attacks. If someone has had a heart attack or has got proven issues with the heart, the lifestyle I've just gone through still applies, and then there is intensive tablet treatment that is extremely useful and is needed. So I enjoy working out. And I like running, although I do that. I don't run every day to keep it consistent, keep myself sustainable with the knees, etc. I work out, I do fitness DVDs and some weights. So I do like exercise and keeping fit. I like the sensation of being fit and healthy and being able to do things without being too out of puff. So in terms of that's what I like to do. And the other thing is actually just eating nice stuff. And you can do that and be healthy. It's possible to do that. So I do enjoy, I'm a bit of a foodie, albeit I'm vegetarian in my own case, but I enjoy eating, and it's you can both be healthy and eat well. It is possible to do that.